minerals in it. The green probably has a spirulina, algae, and nori seaweed. Now, nori seaweed is what they use in sushi wrap. So if any of you guys like sushi wrap, the seaweed for that is in it. Now, that part of the diet isn't really as important for these fish. These guys are primarily carnivores and mainly piscivores, which means they eat fish. So there's also some brine shrimp and krill, fish meal and shrimp meal in here. It's all mixed up. Lots of vitamins are added. And then you put Jell-O in it. Now, it bites out my eye putting Jell-O in a fish food. But that works really well at holding it all together. Now, it's not quite the same Jell-O you kids are familiar with or might get at home. There's no sugar in it. There's no cool flavors like grape or cherry in it. Now, this is just a very small part of what they're going to get. In a couple of minutes, they're going to get a little bit of seafood. So we like to feed this out first. It's kind of like for kids who give them their vegetables first before they get their dessert. We want to make sure they're going to eat it. Now, you're going to see our stingrays are starting to come up. They do know when it's feeding time. They kind of, I think, sense the activity. They kind of know the time of the day that it's going to be. They kind of smell a little bit of the food in the water. Now, we did train them to come to this one particular spot in the aquarium. That allows us to get a really good look at them. We can individually identify all 7 stingrays. And this gives us a good opportunity to know whether they're eating, not eating, and how they look. And for you guys, you get to see the underneath side of the ray. That's something normally you don't get to do. If you were to see one out in the ocean, you're going to see it along the bottom. Or even in here, normally you just see them on the bottom of the aquarium. Now, we have one really big female. She's a little over 16 years old. We have 4 other females, they're about 4 years old, that kind of vary in size. And then 2 males. Now the males are the smallest. And in the stingray world, females are always a lot larger. A lot of times they're at least twice the size, or even a little bit more than that. That has to do with them getting wide berth, where they might have anywhere from 2 to 8 pumps at a time. Even with sharks, usually the female sharks are a little longer and a little bit bulkier. Now you're going to see them come up, grab a few pieces of food, and then head in back, maybe swim around, and then they'll come back up. So usually not all 7 are right up front. But I think what we'll do is start throwing out a little bit of seafood broadcast. That is what really gets the fish excited in here. We're going to throw out a bunch of food. Now, on any given day, we got a variety of food in our kitchen. We like to share that all around the zoo. So all the different departments here, it could be in the aquariums, could be our room, the penguins, some of the other birds and mammals. We like to share it so that we don't waste any of our seafood. But also it could give everybody a little opportunity to use some variety. Now the fish really get excited for this today. There's some brine shrimp and krill, some squid, clam, shrimp, and a whole host of fish that we cut up. Capelin here, mackerel, cod. So it's kind of a variety they're getting. Now there's about 250 fish, maybe 40 species of fish in here. Now there's one family of fish that comprises a good chunk of the tank, and that are the jacks. Now those fish are going to be the ones that look kind of like tuna. The biggest are the coral jacks. They're about 3.5 feet long, 50 pounds. And there's quite a few of them in here. There's also some smaller fish in here. Lots of little grunts and snappers and fromas. Now you have mentioned that Goliath grouper. The Goliath grouper right now, we estimated maybe a little over 100 pounds. They get, you know, upwards of that 600, 800 pounds. Now that's going to be a fish that's really old. This particular Goliath grouper maybe has doubled its size since we had it. We've had it for about 19 years. So those guys are probably a fish that lives 50 to 100 years. They're going to be a pretty long-lived fish. We also have some tarpon that are pretty big size. Right now they're about 4 feet long, and they get upwards of maybe 7 feet. Now I think Christoph is trying to feed another eels. What he's got is a long pole, and then he puts a fish on the end of that stick or a spear on there. Might be good, something good for the state fair. They always got things on the stick. But for our moray eels, what he's going to do is offer that. If they're hungry, they'll eat it. If not, we move on. These guys only eat maybe 3 times a week, roughly. They're all fairly close to adult size, and they're not very active, so the metabolism is a lot slower with these guys, so they don't need to really eat a tremendous amount of food. Now, generally, these guys are going to hide out in caves and crevices, but they do know when it is feeding time. I think they smell the food, sense the activity, and so those guys start coming out. They're generally a little more active at night. Now we're going to kind of continue feeding all of these animals, but it looks like Christoph has got down on the feed platform. He's going to put a long feeding stick down in the water. It's actually a snake handling tong that we use to feed our sharks. And he's going to offer some blue runner, mackerel, menhaden, maybe a little herring. We like to give them variety. Variety is always good. That ensures they're getting a lot of good nutrition. And we do put some vitamins and supplements in there. We're going to offer about 1.5 pounds of food, roughly, per sand tiger shark. So over the week, that comes out to about 4 to 5 pounds. Now you might think, these are pretty good sized sharks, and they're not really getting a lot of food. But they don't technically need a lot of food. Now, our 3 younger ones get a little bit more than our older ones. They're still growing, so they tend to need a little bit more food. Sharks are really efficient at digesting their food. Now, we digest their food probably about 4 to 6 hours, roughly, whereas a shark, it can take upwards of a couple of days to completely digest their food. So they're very efficient. But also, sharks are cold-blooded. Now, being that they're not a mammal and warm-blooded, they don't generate body heat. That's a massive energy savings for them, so that means they don't have to eat as much food. Now, I'm going to see how we're going to do today. We have 2 older males in here. They're a little bit thinner if you see them compared to our juvenile ones. We have them for about 19 years. They're about 23 years old. We have 3 juvenile ones that are probably in the neighborhood of 3 years old, and then another one that's about 6 years old. Well, why don't we send it back downstairs to you, and we'll see what we have for questions in the audience.
Okay. Does anybody have any questions for our aquarists today? Raise your hand. What's the eel
here? All right. Well, Christoph was offering them some squid. They're probably either mackerel or herring. They do really like the squid. And they kind of vary it up a little bit, but out in the ocean, the large moray eels like these green moras tend to eat fish. Smaller moray eels tend to eat maybe things like shrimp and other little animals like that.
Any other questions? I was over at the dive show earlier, and I noticed that the aquarist got into the tank with the fish and was feeding them, and there are sharks in that tank. Why don't you get into the tank here and feed the fish here?
Well, you know, with this exhibit, we do dive in here, but we only dive in here sporadically for doing cleaning. Now, you're going to find a diver in the trap every day feeding them.